Good morning. I'm Dr. Sudhindra Arur, consultant neurologist at Malti Manipal Hospital. So in neurology, we see a wide variety of conditions. But the main thing is I'll just be talking about one common condition over here, that is epilepsy. Or in other words, it is known as recurrent fits. Now, everybody knows about epilepsy. So what is epilepsy? It is a condition where there is excessive abnormal epileptic discharges occurring from the brain. The normal brain has electrical activity. So that electrical activity, when it is much higher, more intense, that can lead to an epileptic attack, or in other words known as fits. Now the same fits, when it occurs multiple times, we classify that as epilepsy. So epilepsy is a very common condition. It can occur to anyone, right from the womb onwards, child in the womb onwards, up till geriatric population, old age. Anyone can, epilepsy can occur to anyone. So this main thing, there are two main conditions which cause epilepsy. There are a whole host of conditions, but two main things cause epilepsy. Number one, if there is a structural damage to the brain. Second, if there is a functional damage to the brain. What do you mean by structural damage? By structural damage, we mean a brain which has had some kind of an impact. It could be a trauma, it could be a road traffic accident, it could be, as we commonly seen in children, post-delivery, if they do not cry immediately, oxygen supply becomes down, and then they have brain damage. So any kind of brain damage can lead to epilepsy. That is one condition. Second thing, and there are many conditions in this, that is one basic condition. Second condition is functional damage in the brain. Now, what do you mean by functional damage? It means that with the brain, there is a normal electrical activity. Now, this electrical activity, if it becomes excessive, very high, abnormal, then that can lead to epilepsy. That is called functional damage of the brain. This is a condition which can occur to anyone. It can happen to anyone at any point of time. So it is far easier to control functional damage rather than structural damage. I'll come to that in a little while. Now, apart from this, what are the types of epilepsy? The common type which everyone knows of, that is commonly seen in these Bollywood movies, is where the patient just goes into a generalized stiffening of all four limbs or shaking and then loses consciousness. That is just one type of epilepsy. There are several more epileptic types. There are some epilepsies which are very hard to spot. A patient just going blank without any response, with a little oromotor automatism, something like this, with a few hand movements, that can also be epilepsy. There are some epilepsies which are usually picked up in school by the school teacher, which they say that the child is extremely distracted in school and there is attention deficit. Turns out to be the child might be having absence epilepsy. So there are various types of epilepsies, not just the generalized epilepsies. So why I'm talking about this is, it is very, very important when you are looking at a patient with epilepsy to first diagnose the type of epilepsy. See, because there are a lot of medications for epilepsy. There are more than 20 different drugs. You can't just add all drugs at the same time. Some drugs work for different types of epilepsy. Some drugs can worsen epilepsy. So what happens is, very important when the patient first comes, to take a detailed history and identify the type of epilepsy. Once you identify the type of epilepsy, it becomes very easy to decide what medication. Some medications are only for one type of epilepsy, some are only for another type of epilepsy. So first is the history. A good history will make your life very easy. Most of the investigations will depend on the history. So once you decide what type of epilepsy the patient has having, then there are other investigations, mainly two things. One, we look at MRI, that is to see if there is a structural damage in the brain. Next, we do the most important thing, that is EEG. EEG is nothing but electroencephalogram. That is a machine which will help us identify the brain waves, the type of discharge that is occurring in the brain. So that will tell us how much of epilepsy is there, the discharges, where it is coming from. So that gives us an idea what kind of medications. So to sum up, you just need a good history to identify the type of epilepsy, MRI to rule out any structural damage, EEG to find out where it is coming from. Based on this, we can decide the medication. Now, the medication part is different, but I'll come to some few other points. That is, mainly in epilepsy, there are a lot of misconceptions. Now, epilepsy in functional abnormal, see, 70% of the people in general have epilepsy because of just a functional weakness of the brain. They're perfectly fine in every other aspect. They don't have any structural damage, but they have epilepsy because of the functional weakness. Now, in these patients, 80 to 90%, even as high as 95% in some cases, they can do all their regular activities without any problems, with medications or even without medications. They can be cured also. So the misconceptions that we commonly see are that epilepsy can be spread. That does not happen. It is not a disease which can spread from people to people. And epileptics cannot marry. That is one more misconception. That is also definitely wrong. Epileptics can marry. They can have as normal life as any other person. They can do their regular activities. They can play. They can work. They can achieve anything that they want to achieve. There is no boundaries. It is all in the mind. The boundaries are only in the mind. It is a very, very, very simple disease in a great number of ways, because there are excellent medications to control and also to cure epilepsy. So these are some of the things that I just wanted to highlight. So to just sum up, epilepsy is a condition which is very, very, very straightforward and very simple in most cases. You don't have to fear epilepsy. You don't have to get really worried or worked up about epilepsy, because most of the time it is because of functional weakness, and that there are very good medications. The whole the treatment modality in epilepsy is a good history and investigations in the form of MRI and EEG. History is the most important. Once you identify the type of epilepsy, treatment becomes very, very, very simple. And here at Malti Manipal Hospital, we have an excellent team of neurologists as well as support staff and nurses who can identify different types of epilepsy and decide the course of medications. There's no point in just doing investigations. So this is what we wanted to say. Thank you.